Hey, what's up you guys? My name is Buck Parker. I'm a board certified general surgeon. In this video, we're gonna talk about appendix function or function of the appendix. So if you're wondering what the hell the appendix does and why do we have it, and nobody can explain this appendix thing, you're about to find out. So first I'll tell you a little story about the appendix. One time, I had finished residency, I'm sitting home, I'm on call, I'm like, you know, sitting around waiting for business to show up, and I start to get this pain in my gut. And I'm on call to take the appendix out, right? I mean, that's like one of the things I do on call. But I get some belly pain. And you know, like during surgery, we're kind of rough. We poke holes in your belly, we sew it up, we inject things. Doctors are just like not that nice. And especially when you're awake, you know, injecting like lidocaine stuff, sometimes I don't have a lot of time, and I don't really have time for you to sit there and wait for me to be all, you know, lovey-dovey and whatever. That's like for the psychiatrist and shit. I got things to do, right? Like, I gotta get this done. So I just like usually cram that needle in there and inject a bunch of lidocaine. You'll be numb in a second. It'll hurt like hell for a second, but whatever. So I'm sitting at home and I get this belly pain. It was like, not too bad. You know, the old scale, you know, with the frowny face and the happy face. Over here is 0 and over here is 10. So on a scale of 1 to 10, the worst pain you ever had was a 10, right? So mine's like a 4. And I'm like, okay, it'll go away. Not a problem. And then it didn't. And then it got worse. And then it was in the right lower quadrant. And you know that if you watch my other videos, that the appendix is in the right lower quadrant. And I started to get a little nervous. I was like, do I have appendicitis? Well, my history and my physical exam was not consistent with appendicitis, but I didn't give a shit because I was in a lot of pain. So I went right to the freaking emergency room and I saw some of my friends there because I know them and the ER guys. And I said, Will, I think I got appendicitis, man. And he's like, okay, well, we'll put you in, blah, blah, blah. I told him what's going on. He was kind of like, yeah, you don't have appendicitis. I was like, no, I do. I have it. Well, I'm in deep shit because I'm on call. You gotta call somebody else, another surgeon. I was like, I don't like that other surgeon too, but call him. Not that guy, that guy. So they put me in the ER, they gave me some Toradol, gave me a little lactated ringers, if you know what that is, little fluids, IVF. Like in a half an hour, it went away. Wasn't appendicitis. I'm so weak, it's pathetic. So that's my story about appendicitis. It's not a very good one, but that's my perspective. So let's talk about the function of the appendix. So we take the appendix out a lot and people say, hey, do I need this thing? What does it do? Why do I have it? All this stuff. And so I usually say, no, you don't need it and you'll be fine after. And people go, kind of give me the eye like, what are you talking about? How do you know I don't need it? Why do I have an organ that I don't need? How does that work? You're bullshitting me. You're taking this out because you want my money. That's not the truth. I don't do that. I don't like to do surgery. I like to do surgery, but I don't like to do it if I don't need to do it. I'm not doing it for money. Like, I get paid like just by I get paid. It doesn't matter how many surgeries I do. Some guys it does. I don't. It doesn't matter. Anyway, so that's what happens is people say, I give them the spiel and appendicitis, and I say, I'm gonna take your appendix out, and they say, what's the function of it? What am I losing? And so that's probably what you're asking yourself too. And don't worry, I'm gonna get to that. So the function of the appendix in the adult is really probably negligible or 0. We do think that in the fetus, it has some type of function to help us our gut kind of form, okay? And it's like super scientific and way freaking boring, and I do not wanna tell you about this. But just know that in week 11 or so, 12, when the fetus is forming, it helps the rest of the gut form normally. And then in childhood, we do think that maybe has some type of immune function. There are immune cells in the appendix, and we think that also it possibly is a storage for bacteria, like the good bacteria in the gut. And some people say, well, the appendix stores the good bacteria, so when you have like an infection in the gut, in the colon specifically, it can reboot that the colon normal flora is what we call regular bacteria in the gut. So those are really the function of the appendix. It really starts to wane in adulthood. And you know, most people, well, we think that by the time you're an adult, it really does not have a lot of immune function. In kids, it can be, when you just have a viral illness, it can it can look like you have appendicitis because there's so much immune cells in there, or so many immune cells in there, that they proliferate. They get you, the kids get really sore, they get real tender in the right lower quadrant, right where the appendix is located, and it looks like appendicitis. So that can be confusing sometimes, and that's because of the immune cells in the appendix. So that's a generalized, no one really knows for sure, let's put it that way, the function of the appendix, but that's what we think at this time. And so I hope that video helped you clear up some questions that you had. I hope you like these videos. If you do, I wouldn't mind if you subscribe to my channel, that'd be awesome. Like the video if you do like this, and share it if you think somebody else could use it. So I will see you in the next one. Thanks, take care.